Hey, what's going on, viewers and subscribers? We are back again with another video from Creedom Publishing Company. Before we get started, make sure you hit that subscribe button so you can stay tuned to all our video uploads. Also, make sure you check out the Creedom of Speech blog on our website at www.creedompublishing.com.
What's going on, viewers and subscribers? You are back again with another video from Creedom Publishing Company. We are doing an unboxing. Well, not truly an unboxing. I apologize for that. It's not an official unboxing. Actually, I got some water on my book. But it is a quality review of the Ingram Spark paperback book, which are these on the right. It was going to be an official unboxing, but unfortunately, we're having a really bad rainstorm here in Philadelphia. And this is what our box looked like when I got home. So it was soaking wet, and I had to get the books out of the boxes ASAP so the books didn't end up looking like the boxes, all soaking wet. So it's not an official unboxing, but I haven't looked at the books yet. I haven't checked out the quality yet, so it's official. The review is going to be official and honest. So if you checked out our other videos, we just completed the video for the hardback versions of Ingram Spark. We did an unboxing and review of that, and we compared it to the CreateSpace paperback, which are these on the left. Just so you know, the books on the left are paperbacks from CreateSpace. The book on the right are paperbacks from Ingram Spark. Both print-on-demand companies. So, we compared, in the last video, we compared the Ingram Spark quality of the paper and the printing, and we compared it to CreateSpace's paperback. So, this time we'll compare these two versions, because they're both paperbacks, and we'll compare we'll review the quality of the Ingram Spark first before we do the comparison. So, just to start with a review of the Ingram Spark book, and just from what I can tell, it looks very, 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 very good from the cover. It looks very good. It looks definitely actually identical to the CreateSpace version, so it definitely looks good. The quality of the cover is very good. One of the things you might notice if you checked out the other video, the hardback version, the cutoff. We mentioned the cutoff for the hardback because they cut the books differently. Obviously, they, as you can see a little bit, they actually fold over the hardback cover. So, depending on your type of image you submit for your book cover, the front design, it may get cut off like these or the heads, which is not really that bad. But it's just something you may take into consideration because in the paperback, it doesn't happen. It stays nice and crisp and clear. So, from the outside, I could tell, there are no errors on the outside. It actually looks very, very good. We'll get into the inside of it. The printing looks very good. One of the things I immediately noticed is the paper quality. The paper quality is pretty good. It's not, like I said, I want to compare CreateSpace books after I do the actual review, but it's not as good as CreateSpace, but it's still a good quality print book, and I definitely like it. Definitely looks good. The binding is tight, so that's something to take into consideration for people who have books that flow into both pages, which means they have images in their books that flow into both pages. I know some illustrators and authors and designers prefer the image on one side, the text on the other, which makes it easy. You won't have issues of the binding getting in the way of the actual image. But if you do this, if you do a children's book that actually flows, the images flow between two pages, then just take into consideration making sure none of the very important images are in the center, because obviously they'll get binded. So you want to make everything that's important, that's truly important, like great detail, like such as this fire on this playground, the parents pointing. You want to put those separate from the center. The center, you can have images in the center. Oh, I'm on knocking the camera down, excuse me. You can have images in the center, but just make sure they're not pertinent, too pertinent if you're going to do the flow. But the quality looks good. The binding is very tight. The quality looks good. Everything appears to be in order. the quality of the when designing, Ingram Spark requests you use CMYK as the color output, and for create space I use RGB. So these colors are a little bit more flat, I guess, because of the type of paper they use. I believe this is 50 or 70 pound with color ink. So 70 pound white paper with color ink. So it is not bad at all. Very, very good. Very, very good. This is a very, very good quality of book. So Ingram Spark, I will give them a nice rating when it comes to printing. See, like, this is a little tight in here. See, we got a character in here, and that's a little tight for binding purposes, but that's not a print issue when it comes to print company. That's just something, a design, more of a design issue. So it looks good. Overall, looks good. I know I think I gave the paper quality in this book, it's the same. I gave it an 8.5 in the hardback cover of my last video compared to CreateSpace. So I guess I'll stick with that paper quality, and I'll show you the difference. So we'll take this book. I'll try to go to the same page. Or a similar page, but I'll try to go to the same exact page so we can just have a true comparison. And all right. As you can see, you can actually see the light shimmering off the page because these pages are more glossy than flat. These are CreateSpace, and I think this is perfect quality. So I gave them a 10 out of 10 for their quality of book overall. If you haven't seen, go check out our CreateSpace unboxing tutorial video. But like I said, you can see the difference in the printing. The colors come out more, just more vibrant, and I think the pages will be more durable. As the children, over the years, as the children are handling the books and things of that nature, you can actually see the difference. But like I said, the Ingram Spark on the bottom is still good quality, very good quality. But CreateSpace is definitely top notch when it comes to the paperback children's books. So yeah, it's definitely a difference. You see the gloss. You can see just how glossy the pages are in the binding as well. So it's a good book, very good book from Ingram Spark. I would say it compares very well to CreateSpace. I was waiting for these books, and they're very good design. Very, very good design. It actually looks identical. You can see the little binding groove a little bit right here on CreateSpace, and then you really don't see that on Ingram Spark, but that's not a big deal anyway. But they look identical. You will never be able to actually tell without looking at the paper quality and without knowing what you're actually looking for, that you would not be able to tell that there's two different print companies. You would think it was the same one. So that's a testament to the quality of work when it comes to designing the books that both companies do. So like I mentioned before in the other videos, you can't go wrong by using both, especially if you're a self-publisher, author, a small publishing, independent publisher. When you're dealing with authors, when you're dealing with your work, your independent work, use both companies. Because each one has its benefits. Obviously, for overall quality, for books that I recommend you get printed out for yourself, that you use to sell on your own website or use to sell at events, when it comes to children's book, I would go with the CreateSpace, because just because the quality is greater, the uploading process is much easier, but the distribution option that Ingram Spark provides is much greater than CreateSpace. So when you're creating and setting up your titles with CreateSpace and they send you to the expanded distribution option for the setup, make sure you do not click on CreateSpace expanded distribution. For what I've been told, they charge higher wholesale prices than the other companies. So bookstores and libraries rather deal with Ingram Spark when ordering their their books from independent publishers, or all publishers, actually. They'd rather deal with Ingram and LightSource rather than deal with CreateSpace, because CreateSpace has a higher rate. So when you upload your books, you can upload it to Amazon if you choose to. Now, one of the other things that I mentioned in another video is Amazon actually is printing their own paperbacks now. So you may want to upload to them directly, so you won't even have to deal with CreateSpace when in terms of getting to Amazon, because obviously that's one less option you have to go through, and then one less expense you have to go through when receiving your royalty payment. So Amazon, you can deal with Amazon directly for paperbacks and your Kindle books. So CreateSpace is just a very good option to obviously get on the CreateSpace store, and obviously just to deal with your own printing books and your own material. I believe, if I'm not mistaken, hold on, let me just verify it. I believe Ingram Spark is actually more affordable than CreateSpace. I believe CreateSpace is around $4.35 for a book this size. This is around 50 pages, full color, 8.5 by 8.5. And I think this is $4.35. I think Ingram Spark was around $4 even, or around $3.80. I don't have the exact price, but I just definitely know Ingram Spark was definitely cheaper and more affordable than CreateSpace when ordering your own books. Obviously, setting your retail price is a whole nother topic. Obviously, you can set your price for whatever you want, but in terms of getting your own prints and your own proof copies and ordering it for yourself to distribute at your own events and signings and things of that nature, Ingram Spark is actually more affordable. My opinion is go with CreateSpace for children's picture books. So go with CreateSpace because of the glossy interior and just the quality of the book. But like I said, this is a good quality. I'll go 8.5 and 9 with this. I will go 10 out of 10 for CreateSpace. They're all good. And as you can see, obviously, the other books and other colors, they're good. They're perfect books. So this is the actual good example of what I meant by the interior flowing. You see, you have the images on one side and you have the text on another. So you have no issues when it comes to images flowing into the other. So this is the introduction book. It's just giving a good idea of the heroes. So each image is on page and you don't have them flowing to two pages, so it's much easier to work with and much easier to deal with when uploading. In terms of uploading, like I mentioned, CreateSpace is easier. Ingram Spark is very, very difficult. They have very strict guidelines that you need to adhere to just to get your submission accepted, just to proceed with the printing process, and they charge per correction. So you want to make sure everything is complete, everything is the way it should be in terms of your Ingram Spark interior design and your Ingram Spark book cover design, it being proper. CreateSpace is the same way. You want to make sure everything is right as well, but they're a little bit more lenient and they fix a lot more issues than CreateSpace does. I mean, than Ingram Spark does. I apologize. So one of the things I suggested in the last video is download your cover generator template for Ingram Spark, and also you could do it for CreateSpace as well. Make sure you download these templates and make sure you adhere to them. They'll give you the spaces and the boxes where you're supposed to put the text parameters and the limits, so you don't get text cut off. Make sure you follow those. The only difference is when you upload your design, CreateSpace allows you to leave a blank box here and they insert the ISBN for you while they print the books. Ingram Spark does not. When you download, make sure your book is complete. You download the information, the ISBN, the page number, the count. They actually generate this ISBN and barcode for you during your template. So you just have to cut it out the template, put it to the side, and input it yourself, which is obviously very easy to do. But if you're not also a graphic designer, make sure you send that to your graphic designer. Make sure they know to download your cover generator template, or you download it for them, they send it to you in a PDF file, and you can forward that to your designer so they can input the ISBN barcode. Like I said, Ingram Spark does not input it. CreateSpace does. All you have to do is leave a blank space if you wish to. You can always put the design there as well if you want to. So That's my review for EngelSpark and CreateSpace, EngelSpark unboxing. Book quality, children's book. It's very good. Like I said, I give it an 8.5, a 9 out of 10. CreateSpace is definitely a 10 out of 10, and you know why. Make sure you like the video. Make sure you share the video for any self-published author or small publisher, independent publisher that can benefit from looking at these videos and they're thinking about using these two companies or they're thinking about designing. If you have any more design questions in terms of text or you need assistance, you can reach out to us at www.creedompublishing.com. We are here to help you. If you want any advice, if you want any more tips, subscribe to our channel. We upload plenty of videos that help self-published authors and independent publishers. And drop a comment if you want to in terms of things you want to see, things you need help with. Because we have a lot of outlets. We have a lot of people that are very successful in self-publishing in this industry, and they're willing to help. So since that's out the way, I'll just drop the plug for the Crime Fighters books. If you're viewing this, you're looking at the Crime Fighters children book series. The Crime Fighters are a group of superheroes that are based around law enforcement, first responders, and they are basically heroes that your children will love. They are based all around safety. They have devices and gadgets rather than weapons. We want to get away from the weapons and just basically gadgets. This is Faith the Firefighter. She has extinguisher balls and she helps to put those out. This is the Crime Fighters introduction book. This allows your children to get to know the heroes, and they learn about them, they read about them, so when they get to the storybooks, they know exactly who each hero is, and they know exactly who they'll need to solve the problem. This is the first book out of the series, the first storybook out of the series, The Heroes Fight a Fire. Obviously, you have your arsonist in the background. The children learn about what a fire is. They learn about the crime of setting fires to other people's property, and they learn the results. Along with reading the stories, they are allowed to participate in determining which hero is needed to save the day. This gets the kids learning. This gets the kids' brains moving, stimulated, because they're solving the crimes as they're reading along. So they have to think. They have to figure out, who do I need? If there's an injury, I'll need a paramedic. If there's a fire, I need a firefighter or a fire marshal. Frank the fire marshal, Rocco the fire dog, and Faith the firefighter. But if there's an injury, I also need Peter the paramedic. So those are the things, those are the benefits of these stories, these books. The next storybook is The Hero Stop a Thief. And there he is right back there. And during this story, there is a thief that steals from a local fair and he runs with the prizes that he stole from the fair. The heroes and the children have to read along and help the heroes decide which way the thief went and what are some of the clues that led them to determine where the thief went and how they're going to solve the crime. So this is a great book, great family book. This is great for your younger siblings who will love the pictures to read along with their older siblings who can concept the information more, and they can concept the art of investigating more, and they can help each other, and obviously the parents as well to join in. So it's a great family book. There are also chapter books that are coming out this summer for the Crime Fighters for the older children. So this we list this as ages 6 and up. The chapter books will be the same stories but more in depth. So it'll be for the older kids, I would say 10 and up. So they'll get more in depth with actual crime and solving issues from beginning to the end rather than getting clues and help. So it is a great book, great series for children. Make sure you check it out. Obviously, they're definitely a diverse group of heroes, and they're one of a kind. I guarantee you that. And we have been having great reviews from them, from fire departments and public safety individuals and families all over. So make sure you check out www.crime-fighters.com or www.creedompublishing.com. You can check us out on all your social media sites, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat at Creedom Publishing or Creedom Books. It's either one of those two handles, and also Crime Fighters on Instagram and Twitter. So we're all over there. We'll also be doing a review. We have a coloring activity book for the children that has a lot of activities, including math and trivia. so the kids will learn and they get to color and they get to sit there and always get a great educational experience with this coloring activity book from the Crime Fighters. We actually have both, and we'll be doing another review of these books in comparison to Ingram Spark and CreateSpace in terms of printing a coloring book. So look out for that video. It will be coming up next on the comparison and unboxing of an Ingram Spark coloring book. So make sure you subscribe, like, and share our videos. Thank you. Make sure you visit the site. Stay blessed and much success.